On the Medical Watch, how long are COVID survivors protected from getting sick again?
Well, medical reporter Dina Baer goes in search of an answer.
Reinfections are rare, and doctors say it's because the body produces antibodies that remember the virus that causes COVID-19 and mount a defense to keep it from causing illness again. But how long do those antibodies last? There's little research. Some trials say 6 months, others only 90 days. So we did our own unscientific study here at WGN.
Reporters, photographers, and producers worked throughout the pandemic, and WGN saw a handful of COVID infections. We gathered the survivors, ranging in age from the 30s to nearly 60.
It was miserable.
Producer Danielle Johnston was diagnosed in early October. She was sick and scared, feeling as if she couldn't breathe. But once recovered, she was breathing a sigh of relief.
It is freeing. It is saying, okay, well, I've had COVID. I'm obviously going to wear my mask. I'm going to wash my hands. I'm going to do all the things we're supposed to do, but I'm not as stressed about it in the back of my mind.
Like many COVID survivors, including Danielle's husband, Keenan, they think they're protected.
You go through it. You want the silver lining. I was not as concerned for my own well-being. Much more comfortable going out.
Once you had COVID-19, the likelihood of you of getting again is very low. If you have antibodies, that means that you've had some contact with COVID-19.
The antibodies are in the blood.
We'll have her draw your blood and we'll go from there.
One by one.
I know I had it November 10th as my first day.
Our crew rolled up their sleeves.
When did you have COVID?
January 16th.
Their symptoms ranged from very mild to difficult, but no one was hospitalized.
My case was relatively mild. I didn't have any of the respiratory symptoms and just had a sore throat and some body aches and fatigue.
Reporter Mike Lowe was most recently infected in February. He felt certain he would have antibodies.
All of them had one type of antibody that was abnormally high, either the IgG or the IgM.
The antibody test looks for both IgM and IgG. Even though the body releases millions of antibodies, these are specific to COVID spike protein.
Usually IgM comes first. Sometimes it's 2 weeks, sometimes it's a month prior to IgG. IgG comes later, but it's longer lasting.
Each person we tested had some level of antibodies. Ted Parra's were through the roof, even though he had a very mild infection.
These don't always correlate with how mild or severe, asymptomatic, it doesn't always correlate. This is exactly what we would predict to see in someone who had a November infection, that they have IgG antibodies with them, which is a good thing, and it's protective. That means if someone were to sneeze on him and they got, COVID entered them, the antibodies in the memory cells would increase, would isolate that, would take that virus out, and the hope is that it wouldn't grow enough to go back into their mucous membranes and cause them to be infectious.
Here are the results, which bring comfort to former COVID patients and no surprise to doctors following the science. With infections ranging from September to February, everyone has some measure of protection.
If you have positive antibodies, you are protected. The truth is, so far, if you had COVID-19, even a year ago when this all started, you are most likely protected.
Having COVID provides the best antibodies, but the vaccine will as well. The only concern is the variants. In 6 months, those mutations may elude current vaccines and natural antibodies. So be prepared for the possibility of the need for another shot next year.